It's Sandra Lockhart, and I'm a citizen of Acadia. And some Lakay or Yellowknife is very much part of the traditional lands of Acadia. So coming to here tonight has been really beneficial to me to get a better perspective of the future for my grandchildren. Because what I'm hearing is there's a tripart system going on here that we aren't talking about, which is there is the federal government who has a majority of the authority, which is a conservative government, which is going to cut $4 billion of public services. I'm a public service worker. I'm a trade unionist. And I'm an Acadia member. The conservative government, with its majority power in the Northwest Territories, desperately wants to domesticate who I am as a citizen, both as a woman and as First Nations in my homeland. They want to domesticate our treaty. So with them having the major power, I'm to come here inside of Acadia and elect somebody from Yellowknife Center, and it could be Range Lake, right? It could be Frame Lake, depending on where I decide to move or live. And that person, what I've heard, believes in my treaty, believes that they're telling me, you're all telling me that you understand that I should be at the table, or my representative, my chiefs, should be there. But I didn't see that with the AIP. I saw total disrespect to my chiefs and indirectly to me and to my grandchildren. And then we have our leaders. We're underfunded to represent us in our homelands, where the resource extraction, I've heard all night, read about it all day, and I get that, we need to live. And I don't think I've ever heard the chief say that we don't want devolution, we don't want development, but we want to be at the table because we have children to take care of too, and we understand our culture. When everything's done and dug up and everybody wants to go home, because I had the pleasure, and there's a man I admire very well who's lived here for 40 years. He says, I live here, I love the NWT, but I don't want to die here. I want to go home where I was born, and most people do, and there's nothing wrong with that. But my grandchildren's children are going to be left here when the mines are gone. And I've seen too many other countries where there's nothing left. And it's just not minerals. We have water. That's blue gold. So what scares me when I listen to who's holding the power, and right now it's conservative government. Cut the public jobs, get rid of equity, get rid of the women. That's just all of this stuff. And I'm supposed to elect you because we have international trade, free trade agreements going on. Nobody's talked tonight about you can have an economy, but if you don't, and you want to bring more workers up here when you're not looking after your own. And our cultures have always been, we want to share. We've agreed to coexist. We've told you that for how many generations? But there seems to be something lacking when you sit there and it's hurtful. You say to me, yes, we're going to do it. We're going to have you at the table. But then you don't do it. So I don't really have any questions other than the realization that I was confirmed tonight, because I've always heard it since I transferred my treaty from 6 to 8, is that this really isn't a government that we have in the GNWT. What we have in an administrative arm of the federal government. So I'm wondering why it is when we talk about partnerships and going to the table, why it is that MLAs for the GNWT does not want to partner with the leaders of our people, of the First Nation governments, of the land claim groups. Why are you not partnering with us so that the feds don't have so much power? They're taking all the money. They're eroding all of our authority. But it seems like they come riding into town, and it's right now we're going to partner up with you, and they'll just divide and conquer. So anything you say now, I believe every one of you have intentions, because none of us know what the future is going to bring, and Bob knows that. You can go in there with good intentions, but you have to work with what you have to work with. But I sincerely beg, and because I want to cry right now, I'm going to die. Somebody's got to be there after my grandchildren. And you're the ones making the decisions. But the biggest thing is, I am the government. I tell you what to do. You don't come and I put you in office and you tell me, no, this is what I'm going to do. I put you there. So I take elections very seriously. They're not personal. Robert's worked very hard in the years he's been there, and other areas, there's improvement. Arlene, I know, is dedicated in hers. So it's not a question of personalities. It's a question of, what are we going to leave your children and my children when we're not here and when the mines aren't here? What's going to be here? And who's it going to serve? And if we allow the Conservative government to get rid of all the public service workers, well, business can just kiss it up and leave town too. Because you need us to buy whatever you're selling. So we need each other in the north like we've never needed each other before. So I'm asking you to work together as a government for the GNWT and take on the feds. So masi chau.
Masi, Sandra. And what I'm going to do is let any individual MLAs who want to comment on what Sandra had to say to go ahead. And I see a couple of hands. I'll just give you options to respond as we go through. I'll try and keep it brief. Starting with Arlene, YK Center.
Thanks for raising that point, Sandra. That is actually the crux of the reason that I decided to run. Because I've never seen a government so entrenched in their own policy, not the people. So when people ask questions of the GNWT, they spit out a policy that may or may not work. They announce funding that nobody can access because nobody's eligible for it. So we have a government that sort of is navel-gazing and empire-building, and it was clear when they agreed to that devolution agreement with the feds that they totally disrespected the Aboriginal leadership. So to me, that's evidence that they really don't know how to do partnerships. They have no intention of doing partnerships, and everything is all about them. So they do that to the voluntary sector, they do that to the Aboriginal leadership, and they do it to residents, straight out residents. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bob McLeod, did I see your hand up, or do you want to pass?
No, thank you. I think it's the question has been posed. I think it's going to be one of the most critical issues that the 17th Assembly is going to face. I think if we're going to get anywhere, we have to think big, we have to be united, and we have to have a vision of where we all want to go together. And so I think we are going to try to find a way to go forward together, but recognizing that it's something that we all have to work together. I think we all recognize that we're getting squeezed. Devolution is something that we're going to have to address and head on. And I think that the points you raise are very critical to the future of Northwest Territories. Thank you.
Thank you. Robert Hawkins, YK Center.
Thanks, Jocelyn, and thank you, Sandra, both for your observations and certainly for your kind words. They're very touching. I'll just say this and make it short. If we're not united, we're going to be fighting separately and no one's going to be ahead. And that's what the federal government has been doing to the territorial government for many years. They just found new partners to fight with us, you know, the Aboriginal land claiming groups. So we're fighting with them. And I don't mean fist fighting. I just mean struggling over different visions to get. Oddly enough, it's funny. We all want the same thing. We want healthy kids. We want a future. We want jobs, houses. You know, it's funny when you think, boil it down to basics. We all want the same thing, oddly enough. But why do we struggle? I think it's because we've played off of each other. I'll just finish with this. I know the territorial government does try to partner more with Aboriginal governments and Aboriginal people, and I think that's a fundamental we need to solve as we always go forward. That always is a struggle, but it's one that I think is worth fighting through and finding some resolution to our bigger problems. Thank you.
Thank you. Who's next that's interested in commenting? Sorry, Daryl, is your hand up? I can't see it. No. Okay. Moving on to David Wasalti, Range Lake.
Thank you very much. Not to repeat too many of the comments that we've already heard, I think it is really important, and the GNWT has, for the most part, done a really bad job at honest partnerships. There's been a few areas that they've actually been successful at it. I know DOT on the Mackenzie Valley Highway has partnered with the Decho and the Satu, with the Gwich'in, and with the Nuvalu'it, and had everybody at the same table looking at planning a highway, which is shouldn't be as much of an accomplishment for the GNWT as it is, but they're really bad at bringing everybody to the table. I mean, the IAP process is just ridiculous to not have had people at the table and at least had them involved and when we went forward with things. So I think the new government, for me at least, if I'm a part of it, I think has to have an honest take on what partnership actually means and sitting down properly. I mean, we don't have a real engagement strategy for dealing with the federal government, and it has to involve the Aboriginal groups here. We have to have that step forward, and we have to not repeat the mistakes we've already made. Thank you.
Range Lake, Norm Smith.
Hi, Sandra. Thanks very much. And I do, too, come from a union background. So I'd just like to say that I think it's unacceptable for the government not to bring all the stakeholders to the table. I don't know why. I'd like to know why. But certainly, if I'm elected, I'm going to stand up and make sure that this government's accountable for the decisions they make and they're transparent in making those decisions. And we need to bring all the stakeholders together and get things moving. Like, you can't just consult and say, we consulted with you, but we're going to go ahead and do that. We're going to do it anyway. We need to have meaningful consultation, and I think Glenn Abernathy talked about that the other night and talked about it very well. And
sorry, Ethan McKenzie, go ahead. Go ahead. We should have enough time, as far as I know. We're supposed to be out of here by 9 o'clock, as far as I know. Is that still the case?
No.
Yeah. Okay. Go ahead.
Pete McKenzie. Okay, Sandra, over the years, like Chief Sandra Satomi, the biggest thing for the chiefs to bring to this house is that the government listen to its people. And we work together. Everybody comes from a small communities, they have different concerns. But the basic needs is that they want to have a good life for themselves and for their future. The federal government comes in and dictates things, but they have not come in with a blueprint for devolution to help this government, to direct them to a system to get a conclusion for all the people that they will be having consensus with. Consensus government is supposed to be with democracy. And we have to do that and feel it and follow it if we're going to have success. If we keep fighting among ourselves, the federal government just stands back and looks at us.
Thank you. I saw Wendy Bezerro with her hand up.
Thanks, Jocelyn, and thanks, Sandra, for your heartfelt comments. I learned something every time I listen to you, so thank you very much. I supported the signing of the AIP, and at the same time, I was really, really conflicted. Without being in the room with the people that were negotiating and developing the AIP, it was extremely difficult for me as a member to know who was telling me the right thing, and I think there's an awful lot of misinformation that went out and that was spread around and that you know people discussed. I feel extremely strongly that we should go forward with devolution, but we cannot do it unless we have everybody at the table. And I think your point about Aboriginal governments and territorial government banding together to fight the feds is a really valid one, and I don't think, I really, that's not anything that we talk about on a regular basis, and it's certainly not something that I heard in our discussion of the AIP. Thank you.
Thank you. Glenn Abernathy of Great Slave Lake. Sorry, Jeff, did you want to go ahead? Or?
No.
Okay. I didn't see your hand.
No,
apologize.
I just,
go ahead,
Sandra. Okay. The reason one of the reasons I run or am running is that born and raised in the Yellowknife, my children are born here. I will die here. I have nowhere else to go, and that's okay. No, this is my home, and just like you, this is my home, and this is a wonderful place, and it's in my heart. And we need to work together. And that's my reason for being here. I love the place that I live, and I need to treat everybody with respect and move forward with the devolution agreement. My experience with consultation with the government is it's a take it or leave it type of solution, and I think that's what happened with the Aboriginal governments, and a lot left it. So what we need to go back and discuss it again in an honest and transparent way that we can come to agreements and move forward as a community, as the NWT, and then fight against the federal government. Thank you.
And Glenn Abernathy, Great Slave Lake.
Thank you, Sandra. Sandra, you and I have talked many times, and you know how passionate I am about the Northwest Territories. Like Delft, this is my home, and my bones will be buried in the dirt here, just like your bones will probably be buried in the dirt here. I don't agree with everything you said. You indicated that this is not the government of the people, and I believe that it is. I believe that the government of the Northwest Territories. Okay, fair. I believe strongly that the GNWT is a public government, that it is a government for all the people. Do we get everything right all the time? No, but we keep trying. When it comes to devolution, devolution is important for the future of all people of the Northwest Territories. You talked about an agreement to coexist. That means we all have to work together to coexist. That doesn't mean just the GNWT has to work. It means the Aboriginal governments and the non-Aboriginal governments and all people of the Northwest Territories have to be on the same playing field. There's 42,000 of us, 43,000 of us. We all want the same thing. David talked about it earlier. We want healthy economies. We want healthy people. 43,000 people. We should be able to get together and find some real solutions together.
Awesome. Thank you, John. Pat Scott, Great Slave Lake.
Excuse me.
How many more people do we have to find out? Because the clock is really ticking.
The clock is really ticking.
Okay. No, but it's really ticking now.
It's really ticking, all right. The problem is GNWT and Canada have always been in bed together, and the Aboriginal groups haven't even been in the room. It's time the GNWT steps up to the plate and partners and collaborates with the Aboriginal governments. I suggest that instead of the MLAs getting together and having a visioning workshop amongst themselves at the beginning of the assembly, they get together with the Aboriginal leaders and develop a collaborative, cooperative vision for the next 4 years, and then go about doing their own internal visioning so that we see real progress in the next 4 years.
Bob Bromley, Welladay.
Thank you. Good question. I mentioned three ways of cooperating with Aboriginal partners tonight: mineral development, economic development, devolution. Last election, I made the argument that we can no longer have both more and better, so let's aim for better. Growth is no longer making most people wealthier, but instead generates inequality and insecurity. And it's bumping up against physical limits like climate change and peak oil. New info shows that when growth does provide new wealth, it is no longer making us any happier. The foundation of a healthy economy is healthy and vital children, families, and communities. I think our Aboriginal partners will agree with this and will be willing collaborators to that end. Mossy.
Thank you. And Mark Bogan, Welladay.
Sandra, thank you very much. Your comments were heartfelt, and again, thank you. Sandra, a person like me comes here a lot. These front guys will tell you that I come to the Legislative Assembly a lot. And during the last, 12 years, sometimes the reasons why I come here have, to be protesting and so on, and raises a brow around a place like this. Regardless, what I hear from our MLAs is how it's easier to get things done if we have an MP, Western Arctic MP, who's also affiliated with the party in power. I hear that a lot from these MLAs, and my question is why? If we elect an NDP MP, why is it harder to get things done as opposed to electing a Conservative MP? So if we're going to talk about working together, then that really seems to be the ground roots of a problem.
Thank you. And finally, Dave Ramsey, Camlake.
Thanks very much, Jocelyn. Thanks for the comments, Sandra. I've been an MLA for the past 8 years, and I've often struggled with trying to understand why we don't have better relations with Aboriginal governments in the Northwest Territories. When you consider the majority of our members are Aboriginal, you look around the Northwest Territories, the majority of Aboriginal leaders in the Northwest Territories are former members of the Legislative Assembly and had leadership roles to play in previous governments. Why can't we get together? I think, we certainly, when the next government comes in, this has got to be front and center. I think if we're going to move forward, we have to be working on the same page. We have to get our Aboriginal governments back to the table. We have to work together. That's the only way forward, is to work together. And the new government is going to have that front and center as soon as they come into power. And that should be one of the first meetings they have, is with the Aboriginal governments across the Northwest Territories, and try to move this thing forward. And that is devolution, and is having everybody at the table. Thank you.
And thanks to everyone for their thoughts on this very important question.